Okay, in this video, video number 2.3, that is chapter 2, video number 3. In this video, we are mainly going to discuss about the steady flow energy equation. For this, we need to know one by one by this sequence. First, we need to know about open system, another method of analysis of the system. A flow process we see one by one. Earlier videos we already discussed about the open system means where there is a system which allows both mass and energy transfer take place. Such a systems called as a open system, where there is only energy transfer, no mass transfer take place. That is a closed system, where in case of open system both energy and mass transfer take place. That is a open system. Generally all the engineering devices are the in open system only. Okay, open system mainly mass transfer across the boundaries of the system. Mass transfer take place across the boundaries of the system. All engineering devices are the comes category of open system. Suppose a steam turbine, which is a open system where there is a mass transfer across the system boundary. Suppose this is a steam turbine, this is a shaft, which this is a dotted line which indicates a control surface. Let it be a system. When the high pressure stream is entering at the inlet at section 1, and this high pressure stream is works on the rotor blades and produce or transfer some amount of work take place here, and after that low pressure stream will leaves from at section 2. In this case, if this high pressure stream is considered as a system, in this case whatever the steam is entering and works high pressure stream is comes and works on the rotor of the turbine blades and leaves from the exhaust valve. In this case we need to analyze about the system. That is the system. If we take it is a steam, for this analysis of the system there is a two methods for the analysis of the system. First method, let the high pressure steam is our system. In this case, for this analysis we focus attention on the certain quantity of the steam which is entering in the turbine. For this we have to trace and monitor where the steam is taking place, and we have to focus and we have to follow up the where the amount of the steam is entering and how the heat transfer take place. That is the all the energy comes in this category, whatever the work transfer take place and heat transfer take place, and we have to take into the account of all the energy across the steam is flowing and at the inlet and exit. This type of method we call as a Lagrange's method in the fluid mechanics. This method is a Lagrange's method of in fluid mechanics. Another method is the second method, which is the instead of concentrating our attention through a certain amount of system throughout the path, we just focus in the second method we only concentrate on a certain amount of the space in the region, certain amount of the region. Suppose if your attention is steam is entering here and leaving here, our attention is focusing only at this certain region and start calculating whatever the effects on that. Such type of study of analysis we called as a control volume. This is a control volume method. Control volume method. This is very convenient and very widely using the type of analysis method is the control volume. In further study, most of the cases studying the problem is through the control volume method. So it is called as a control volume. Generally, in the flow process, fluid flows through a control volume. Suppose this is a control volume, fluid is flows through a control volume. Generally, all thermodynamic properties may change with respect to the time, or maybe with respect to the space or coordinates. Thermodynamic properties like a pressure, temperature, volume, these are all the thermodynamic properties in the flow process may change with respect to the time and a space. A space also with changes take place. If the properties are varying in the control volume, the properties in case of the study flow process. In this case, if the process is said to be steady flow process, means only the thermodynamic properties are change with respect to space coordinates only, but with respect to the time, the properties are not changed with respect to the time. Such a process is called a steady flow process. It may be changed with respect to the space. Okay. Such type of flow process is a steady flow process. Example, suppose this is a turbine. This is a turbine. High pressure steam is entering from here at section 1 and leaves here at section 2 at any instant of, okay, suppose this is a time t1 at 0 seconds, time t2 after 5 seconds, time t3 after 10 seconds at location A, B, C. Suppose this is a location A, this is a location B, this is a location C. Okay, suppose if we take the velocity, example one of the property take it is a velocity at point A at time at 0 seconds, if it is a 2 meter per second, after 5 seconds if you observe at the location A, the velocity of the property is still 2 meter per second. After 10 seconds also, if you go and observe, the velocity is 2 meter per second only. From this, the property do not vary with respect to the time, that is dt by d tau is a 0. Such a flow process is called as a steady flow process. It may be changed or may not be changed with respect to the space. Okay, with the space or coordinates, maybe it is a 5 meter after at point B. At point C, it is maybe a 10 meter per second. But after 5 seconds, it is still 5. After 10 seconds, it is a 5. Here also, 10. If you observe here, The property do not change with respect to the time. It may be changed with respect to the space. Such a flow process is called as a steady flow process. This information is sufficient before going to writing the study flow equation for a mass and energy balance equation. Okay, now we are going to see how the mass balance and energy balance for a simple study flow flow process, how the equation I am going to write. We see, let it is a control volume of a study flow process. This is a study flow process, a study flow device. This is a control volume. Here one stream of mass flowing at inlet section 1 and another mass of stream is leaving at section 2, and here the mass flow rate is the m dot 1 is the mass flow rate, and the mass flow rate and the stream is entering at velocity v1, that is a meter per second. Mass flow rate, that is a kg per second, and with a pressure p1, that is a pascal, and a specific volume, that is meter cube per kg, and a specific internal energy, that is the u1, specific internal energy per unit mass energy at a cross section area a1, that is a meter per second, meter square area. Similarly, the amount of stream is leaving at outlet section 2 is the mass flow rate m.2, and with the outlet velocity v2, a specific volume mu2, pressure p2, specific internal energy mu2, cross section area is a2. Okay, it is a device where there is no accumulation of in the mass. Here first writing the mass balance equation. From the conservation of mass, if there is no accumulation within the device, the mass flow rate entering is equal to the mass flow rate of the leaving. If there is no accumulation of the within the device, mass flow rate of leaving from control volume, that is the m.1 is equal to m dot 2. Dot 2 is rho q 1, can be write as into the rho q 2. Rho is the density, q is the rate. Density can be write as a specific volume in terms. Q equal to area into velocity. This is a meter cube per second. Area is a meter square. Velocity is a meter per second. Okay. A Q can be substituted as a A1 V1. Density can be written as a specific volume U1. Similarly, A2 V2, that is a mu2. This is the mass balance equation. Now write the energy balance. Now writing energy balance equation. Energy balance, here also there is no accumulation of the energy, can be write the work transfer he is the dou w by dou tau, and if there is a heat transfer through the control surface, this is a control surface, can be right. The amount of heat transfer through this device is the dou q by dou t. From the conservation of energy, if there is no accumulation of the energy within the control volume, the total rate of flow of all energy streams entering into the control volume must be equal to the total rate of flow of all energy through the leaving the control volume. Okay, can be right is a energy of all total energy of all entering in is equal to the total energy of all which is the leaving should be equal from the conservation of energy. Now I am writing m dot 1 e1 is the energy should be equal to the dou q by dou t is equal to the m dot of 2 energy e2 plus dou w by dou t. From the first law of thermodynamics I am writing the equation. Now here the work transfer may be take place by the two ways. One is the external work, another is the flow work. External work, it may be any the turbine work, maybe flow work means it is the displacement work by the stream. This is the P1 and this is a P2 V2 minus P1 V1 P2 V2 by V1. This can be write if you need means we can write in this way. We know the displacement is a PV is the displacement work. From the relation rho equal to mass by volume can be write as a m by rho can be rho into specific volume in place of velocity v. Okay, volume you can substitute m into rho 1. Okay, P2 here we can write, here it is a O2 into dm to minus P1 V1 dm 1. This is the displacement. These are the two types of work involved here. Okay, this and this one, this is the work transfer involved here. Now can we write the total amount of work transfer is the dou tau plus P2 V2 in terms we are writing in, this is the in joules, so here also in joules P2 V1 dou m by dou tau. This is a equation. This is the equation 1 and this is the equation 2. If you substitute the equation 2 in equation 1, we will get now we seen W in place of W can be right. This is the in place of W we can write. This is the external work. and P2 V2 do M by Dm by D tau and P1 V1 T1 D tau. This is the equation 2. Now E1 E2 are the energy. The energies are carried in and out of the control volume with unit mass of fluid, where E is the potential energy, kinetic energy, internal energy. Potential energy is the per unit mass. So per unit mass GZ, generally MGZ is the potential energy, MV square by 2 is the kinetic energy, mu is the internal energy. From the datum line, if it is the Z1, similarly from the datum line, from these two, you can write this is a Z2. For inlet and exit, this is the equation 3. If we substitute 2, 3 in equation 1, we will get m dot is the dou m by dou tau. Okay. Dot indicates means rate, mass flow rate. If you substitute this dou m by dou tau, here we are talking about E is the energy per unit mass, so there is a no m. Okay, can write GZ1 V1 square by 2 internal energy U1 plus dou Q by dou tau is equal to the dou M by dou tau of GZ2 V2 square by 2 U2 square. Now I am doing only simple substitution only, and now in place of D, writing the equation 2, here we will get tau plus P2 V2 M2 by dou tau P1 V1 dou M by dou tau. In this, if you take, this is the equation of 4. Now dividing this equation with mass flow rate, on both sides, dou m by dou tau, here also dou m by dou tau. Okay, get cancelled, dou tau get cancelled, dou m by dou tau entirely get cancelled. Here also dou m by dou tau is get cancelled. Dou m by, dividing on both sides, here also dou m by dou tau get cancelled. What is the left here? I am writing here itself only. Whatever the here entirely get cancelled, so you can erase this. Here also both get cancelled, you can erase this. Here also both is get cancelled. Here is only tau and this tau is get cancelled, and here also entirely get cancelled. Here only a tau and tau get cancelled. So you can write here also I am writing here, what is the left here is the dou Q by dou M. Here also the amount of work dou w by dou m. This p1 comes at this side, the equation, okay, the equation get p1 v1 plus u1 plus gz1 p1 v1 comes left hand side, left hand side p1 v1 u1 plus g1 plus v1 square by 2 is equal dou q by dou m is equal to the RHS p2 v2 plus u2 plus gz2 plus v2 square by 2 dw by dm dm. Now arising this, we already know enthalpy h is equal to the u plus pv. In place of now the equation, we are substituting here, u plus pv can be replaced with the h1, can be right with the h1 plus gz1 plus v1 square by 2 dou q by dou m is equal to h2 plus v2 square by 2 gz2 dw by dm. This is a simple study flow and a g equation. If there is a only one mass flow and only one mass out, if there is a more than one in and one out, the equation can be write as a, suppose if the study flow process, if there is a more than one inlet and more than one outlet, the equation, the mass balance can be write as follows: m dot 1 plus m dot 2 of all in of left hand side, it should be equal to the right hand side of all outlets, m3 dot plus m4 dot. This is the mass law of conservation of mass if there is no accumulation in the control volume. Similarly, for energy equation also, energy balance equation also can be write as follows, m dot 1 plus, if there is a 2, h1 plus v1 square by 2 plus gz1 plus m dot 2 of h2 plus v2 square by 2 plus gz2 dou q by dou tau of LHS is equal to the outlet of the mass, that is the m3 of h3 plus v3 square by 2 gz3 plus m4 of, this is the 3, 4 v4 square by 2 gz4 plus the amount of external work done on the control device, the external work done here, we can write such a way. Now it is understood, okay. Now study flow, energy equation, now finally we written. Thank you.